Hello, and a very pleasant good day to you wherever you may be. We are back with another one of our top MLB players lists of all time. Today, Gabriel's bringing you the top 10 left fielders, and we hope you're having a wonderful summer out there. We're going to jump right into it. Gabriel, go ahead.
So, left field is definitely a very good position, my position, so it's my favorite position. But, yeah, so there's a lot of good players, a lot of really good fielders, too, and a lot of good hitters. So we're going to get right into it, starting with number 10. That's going to be Lou Brock. Lou Brock played from 1961 to 1979 with the Cubs and the Cardinals. And in his career, he had a .293 average with a .753 OPS, 149 home runs, 900 RBIs. He's a Hall of Famer, a six-time All-Star, and an MLB Player of the Year. He is one of the greatest speedsters of all time, as he is second on the all-time list with 900-something. And yeah, so he's going to be number 10 on our list. Coming in at number 9, it's going to be Al Simmons. Al Simmons played from 1924 to 1944, and most famously known with... What did I just say? Most known with the Athletics and Jimmy Fox. In his career, he had a .334 average and a .915 OPS, 307 home runs, 1,828 RBIs. He's a Hall of Famer, a three-time All-Star, and a two-time batting title winner. Now, you might be thinking, wow, those career stats sound like top five. Well, Al Simmons was one of those guys who had, like, four or five insanely good years, and then the rest of his career was kind of meh, but still, he's a Hall of Famer, and that really boosted his numbers up, because I think he had like a five-year stretch where he had an OPS over 1,000 every single year. And now coming in at number 8 is going to be Tim Raines. Tim Raines, another speedster. He has over 800 career stolen bases. He played from 1979 to 2002. And in his career, he had a .294 career average and an .810 OPS, 170 home runs, 980 RBIs. He's a Hall of Famer, a seven-time All-Star. He won a Silver Slugger, he won a batting title, and he won an All-Star Game MVP. Now, when I was trying to do my research, I wasn't sure if Tim Raines took steroids or not, but he didn't. He just did cocaine, which, yeah. That's why he's not really widely known, because his career was kind of pushed down because of that. And yeah, so he's our number 8 guy on the top 10 left fielders of all time. Now coming in at number 7 is going to be Billy Williams. Billy Williams, most famous with the Chicago Cubs, played from 1959 to 1976. In his career, he had a .290 average, an .853 OPS, 426 home runs, 1,475 RBIs. He's a Hall of Famer. He won Rookie of the Year. He's a six-time All-Star, a batting title winner, and he won MLB Player of the Year. He was one of the best power hitters of his generation, and he played with Ernie Banks, I'm pretty sure. I don't know why that Cubs team didn't win anything. But yeah, he was a great all-around player. And yeah, he's number 7. He's the 7th greatest left fielder of all time. Now coming in at number 6 is going to be Pops Willie Stargell. Willie Stargell played from 1962 to 1982, his whole career with the Pittsburgh Pirates. He had a .290 average. Oh, sorry. He had a .282 average with an .889 OPS, 475 home runs, 1,540 RBIs. He's a Hall of Famer. He won MVP back in 1979. He's a seven-time All-Star. He won a World Series MVP and an NLCS MVP and an MLB Player of the Year award. Pops is known to be like a very likable guy. He was always a fun teammate to be around. And he's number 6. He was also a great player. Now coming in at number 5 is going to be Shoeless Joe Jackson. Now, Shoeless Joe Jackson, you might be thinking to yourself, well, why is he on this list? Because technically he did cheat. But during the Black Sox scandal, he actually didn't want anything to do with it. and he tried to convince the owner to stop it, but the Charles Comiskey, the owner of the White Sox, didn't listen to him. So Joe Jackson is going to be number five because I think he at least deserves to be in the Hall of Fame. In his career, he had a 356 average, a 940 OPS, 54 homers, and 792 RBIs. He won a World Series with the White Sox back in 1917 when they weren't cheating. And, yeah, he's probably one of the greatest hitters of all time, and I think he deserves to be on this list. And so, he's number five. Now, getting the top four started, at number four is going to be one of my favorite players of all time, Carl Yastrzemski. Carl Yastrzemski played from 1961 to 1983, all with the Boston Red Sox. In his career, he had a 285 average, an 841 OPS, 452 home runs, 1,844 RBIs. He's a Hall of Famer. He won an MVP. He won the Triple Crown back in 1967. He's an 18-time All-Star, a 7-time Gold Glove winner, a 3-time batting title winner, an All-Star Game MVP, and he won MLB Player of the Year. You guessed it, probably for 1967. And yeah, he's probably one of the best hitters of all time. He was a great fielder out in left field. He was actually pretty underrated fielding-wise because I think everyone just talked about him hitting-wise. And he has a great last name. And shout out to Mike Yastrzemski because you're really good too, his grandson. Now coming in at number three, it's going to be Pete Rose. Pete Rose, another guy on this list who, like, cheated. I'm going to put that in quotations, but he didn't take steroids and he didn't really do anything that would, like, put him into shape. He just gambled, so that's why he's not in the Hall of Fame, but I think he deserves to be on this list, and he's number three. In his career, he had a 303 career average, speaking of the number three, and a 784 OPS, 160 home runs, 1,314 RBIs. He won an MVP. He's a rookie of the year. He won Rookie of the Year, a 17-time All-Star, a 2-time Gold Glove winner, he won a Silver Slugger, World Series MVP, and he's a 3-time batting title winner. As Pete Rose, of course, holds the record with the most hits in his career with 4,256, past Ty Cobb, who was second. Yeah, so Pete Rose, I think he also deserves to be on this list, even though he's not in the Hall of Fame, and he did technically cheat, but not really. Now, coming in at number two is going to be Ricky Henderson. Ricky Henderson played from 1979 to 2003. He's the greatest speedster in MLB history. In his career, he had a 279 average and an 820 OPS, 297 home runs, 1,115 RBIs. He's a Hall of Famer. He won MVP. He's a 10-time All-Star. He won a Gold Glove, a 3-time Silver Slugger winner, and an ALCS MVP. Of course, he holds the record with like 1,400-something stolen bases, just crazy. Holds the record for the most single-season stolen bases with 130 back in 1982, I'm pretty sure. And yeah, Ricky Henderson, he was also a great fielder. He's on this list, and he's number two. And number one, this is pretty obvious. He's known as the greatest hitter of all time, and it is Ted Williams. Ted Williams played from 1939 to 1960, and in his career, he had a 344 career batting average, a 1,116 OPS, 521 home runs, 1,839 RBIs, a Hall of Famer, a 2-time MVP, a 2-time Triple Crown winner, 19-time All-Star, 6-time batting title winner, and a 5-time MLB Player of the Year. He's the greatest hitter of all time. Fielding-wise, he is pretty terrible, but his hitting kind of carried him. That's why he's the greatest left fielder of all time.
Thank you so much for watching this latest video. We really hope you've enjoyed it. As always, we know you're going to agree to disagree. That's fine. That's what these lists are all about. They're all about just generating good conversation. So we hope everyone is having a wonderful summer. It's back to school for us here in just a couple of weeks in Florida. And Gabriel's kind of meh about that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Gabriel's starting middle school and he's kind of meh about it. But I'm sure he's going to have a great year. So enjoy, and thank you so much. Please like and subscribe below, and we'll be back with another video soon.